Hello, my name is Dr. Dan Albright. I'm an orthopedic surgeon at the Raleigh Orthopedic Clinic in Raleigh, North Carolina. I've been here 21 years in private practice, and I specialize in arthritis surgery or joint replacement surgery of the hip and knee. Today, we're going to talk about total knee replacements and what happens during surgery. It's a big operation, as many of you may know already. It's an incision, about a roughly 10-12 inch incision in the front of the knee, in the middle of the knee, and you go down and you expose the knee joint pretty easily. It's a pretty superficial knee joint. And what a knee replacement is a metal and plastic replacement. So you take the end of the femur. I have a model here. The femur is the thigh bone. And right here is the femur. You take a quarter inch about of bone off the end of the femur, and you cement or glue on a cap, a cobalt chromium metal cap on the end of the femur. This is an example of that piece. And all the knee replacements are very similar. The actual model is not vital. What's important is that the implant has been used for years, has been proven successful. So that's the femur. And the next thing you do is you take a quarter inch off the tibia. The knee is a hinge joint, and it's pretty easy to expose it. Like I said, quarter inch comes off the end of the tibia, and you cement in another metal piece. It's a base plate with a little stem that goes down the bone. That's pretty straightforward. And then you put a piece of plastic between the two. This plastic has been around a number of years. There's a lot of good research. The hope is the plastic lasts 20 years. It replaces the cartilage. That goes between the two pieces of metal. Then you're almost done. The last part is the kneecap, the patella right here. You keep patella, most of it, but you shave the under surface off and you glue on a plastic butt in place. So when you're done, everything moves as a unit and moves like a hinge joint, like your normal joint. It's really important to get it the proper tension or tightness and balance the ligaments. And the knee should be straight. A lot of people have a crooked knee when they start, bow leg, knock kneed, crooked leg, and then when you're done, your knee's straight and should move almost fully. And those are the main points about how to do a knee replacement. So in closing, if you have an interest in talking about knee replacement surgery, I'd be happy to see. I'm at the Raleigh Orthopedic Clinic. My website is danalbrightmd.com, and the contact information is there. The number is 919-863-6808 for appointments. Thank you.